said good day, sir!
What is cracking, ladies and gentlemen, dear Dota people? Here we are for the Defense Season 3. My name is Epi, and we have Baguette going up against Quirt 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6 today. So I hope you guys are ready for this match. I certainly am totally looking forward to this. Big shout out before we start to our sponsors, Rockcat, as well as Own3D TV, and of course to you guys for watching. So, highly appreciated. We have some bad news. I think right now bad news sneaking in. We got Orange missing in action. Let us hope that he reconnects ASAP. And what are the good news? The other bad news? No, it's just bad news today. One game, the second game that was scheduled for tonight, which was Mouseboards versus Team Liquid, a team that I've been looking forward to cast for the longest time, got postponed, I think, to the 17th. Was it the 17th? That might actually be it. 17th or 19th of December. So just one game for the Defense Season 3 tonight. So dear Quirt, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, dear Baguette, make it worthwhile. Let's see some amazing shizzle. Jakiro, good start, good start. You got a good AoE disable, Ice Path, beautiful spell. You have some strong strength gain, and you are quite tanky for a support. So starting out quite well, little guy with the French bread in underneath your arm. Quirt on the other side. We're slacking, didn't put their team profile up, so shame on you guys. But, you know, we were sitting in the lobby, and joined Dota Diamond. She's like, alright guys, set your logo. No, she's like, no, you don't have a logo. Too bad. And then she started the game. And then I WTF'd, and then I stopped WTFing as I had to start the recording. But, dear teams, please set your team profiles, because, you know, when the game is running, people will not be able to see who you are, but oh well. For that, for just this reason, Holy Master did the whole, you know, there was a news post a few weeks ago, even right now, I think it was probably a month ago, about Join Dota kind of starting off with a system, kind of a point system, kind of a system in which you can, well, they're just grading the teams essentially. So how punctual are they to games? How polite are they, or like, do they flame a crap load? Are they behaving inappropriately? How often do they use stand-ins, and do they forget little crap like setting their team profile, etc., etc.? And that is one of the things that I personally really like to see in the Dota 2 scene, as we all want the Dota 2 scene to grow. But what do we need in order for the Dota 2 scene to grow? We need large organizations to invest money into the scene. So again, Rockcat, Own3D TV are, of course, on the very forefront of that process happening. But if we want the Dota 2 scene to grow over time, we need companies to invest money, keep investing money, to invest more money over time, so that we're able to keep on casting, to give you quality casts, and so on and so forth, and to just keep the whole thing rolling. And for that to even be considered, if you're like a CEO of a large company and you're like, all right, let's invest some money, where do we put it? Then you want to be sure that those so-called professional players that will be performing within the realms of your tournament are really that professional. And I talked to Toby about this a bunch as well, and I mean, Toby is he has been around for the longest time, just a really experienced caster, of course, and also esports businessman. And he just knows a lot about the whole scene, and yeah, he's hit the nail right on the head when he told me, Epi man, you gotta see these things realistically. This is not, you know, we call it professional Dota 2, but it's not really professional yet. You know why? Because these people that are playing Dota 2, you know, professionally, so you say, they don't make that much money. And as long as you have to worry about, you know, like getting like a job on the side so you can finance yourself, and the Dota by itself, the professional gaming, is not enough to pay your bills, then you don't have professionals. If you're not capable to 100% focus on the game, then you're not a professional. And you I mean, of course, you can do that if you're back at home with mom and dad, but you know, that's not really what you want. You don't want to meet not gonna go there. I was just gonna say, you don't want to meet some nice girls on the LAN and then you want to take them home to mom and dad. At any rate, guys, that's what I'm talking about. We need the Dota 2 scene to grow. We want it to grow. And this is the defense season three. It's just you know, the third attempt to help facilitate that process. Baguette, Jakiro, Gyrocopter, Lone Druid. Like in the Gyrocopter pickup, Lone Druid, of course, he needs some space. He needs that gold coming in. Otherwise, he's not as effective. And if you look over at Quirt's lineup so far, they have the Bounty Hunter, which means track, which means bonus gold, which means good ganking potential, which means we are looking for drawn out team fights. And Undying, the second pick, really kind of underlines this train of thought, as with his skill set, mainly of course is the Soul Rip, the DK, and the Tombstone, he's very capable to tank it up, to tank Snit up, and just stay in the skirmishes and stay alive for as long as possible. Throw that DK out on level 4. It has a tremendously low cooldown. It's an amazing spell, although it got fixed a bit, as it used to give too much HP, which is interesting, because I noticed, you know, that DK, if you hit it on 2 or 3 heroes, it gives you so much HP. And Valve, in the latest patch, or the one before that, I think it was, they fixed the amount of HP that the DK provides Undying. Shadow Demon, one of my favorites, support heroes. Disruption, of course, that Joker spell, you can use it on your allies to save them, you can use it on the enemy to either initiate a gank on them, or to take them out of the team fight, or to take them out of a team fight, and then of course you have those illusions to work against his whole team as well. So Shadow Demon, very beautiful, and that's just one skill. There's a long, even longer range than even longer cast range than his disruption is on his ultimate, that Demonic Purge, which is very beautiful to initiating those ganks, and also to target in big team fights the strongest hero on the enemy side, to slow down his movements. The Purge, of course, slows down the movement by a tremendous amount, and then he slowly regains it over time. That's why it's just a beautiful skill to use during team fights as well, because it diminishes the effectiveness of the enemy carry. Soul Catcher, amazing skill. It is totally underrated in my mind. Having a 50% damage increase, amplification, is ridiculous. And the Shadow Poison, of course, just a beautiful skill as well. In pub games, you usually just, you know, skill up that Shadow Poison, one in Disruption, one in Soul Catcher, then your ultimate, and you're doing good. You can, there's not, if especially if you're babysitting on the safe lane, your carry, and you have a solo long lane hero opposing you, there's no way this guy can win against you. There's absolutely no way. If you understand the hero, and you know the mechanics of the game, and you have a little bit of experience, you can babysit the crap out of your hard carry with the Shadow Demon if it's a 2 versus 1. Of course, you can then stack and pull and do all that shenanigans as well. So far, so good. And I talked my way through the entire ban phase. I'm not going to go over them just yet because you can see them on the left-hand side. More importantly, I want to kind of talk about the Enigma pickup that Baguette just chose. Look at Jakiro, look at Gyrocopter, and look at Lone Druid. If Lone Druid has a good start, he will go for a Radiance. If Gyrocopter gets items up, he will do a crap load of damage with the Flak Cannon. And Jakiro, he's just that backup plan with the Ice Path, the Macro Pyre underneath the Black Hole, and the Dual Breath to kind of sustain the teamfight AoE damage that they need. But Enigma with the Black Hole, he is of course always that key factor. On paper, Enigma is amazing. In a practical sense, Enigma can be very amazing. And it is simply one of the most important heroes to watch out for in the team fights. I mean, Puppy has shown it time and time again how important positioning is and timing on Enigma, and Balls, fucking Mad from a former MTW, he plays a tremendous Enigma, a very underrated Enigma in my mind, but I think he's one of the best Enigmas out there, and just a very interesting hero pickup. An Enigma always makes for a very interesting game. And Quirt, on the other hand, now pick up Windrunner in response for their fourth pickup. Just the long lane solo, you know. They can even put a mid, they can have a tri lane, even Undying Shadow Demon with one Joker. They can have Windrunner in mid then, and then Bounty Hunter on the other lane. And they can even have him on the safe lane, so he has a little bit of an easier time, and just have that aggressive tri lane, just take that hard lane, that suicide lane. So Windrunner, just a beautiful hero to have, and a Shadow Fiend. That's probably going to be their safe lane or solo mid hero right there. Love Shadow Fiend. He needs a good start, though. Also, because if he doesn't get that good start off, then he is really hard to play. He has low HP, then gets picked off easily. And if you look at Baguette's lineup with the Nightstalker last pick, oh boy, that guy gonna get dove like hell, and he will have a really, really tough time. All right, Nightstalker, the last pickup from Baguette, love it. He will be making sure that the early to mid game, well, let's not say early game, but more like the early mid game, with the potential of the late mid game to late game, is there for Team Baguette. Because with the Night Stalker, you need that first night. As soon as 6-minute mark hits, you need to have a plan. You need to know, what am I going to do? to try and snowball the Shizzle out of control, and what items will I go for? Do I want to go for that BKB with magic immunity, or do I want to have an Aghanim Scepter for that all-around vision, unobstructed vision, and provide my team the support in that sense? So Nightstalker will have to think about that. Enigma will just need to farm up, get his items up, and then make sure that things remain fine. I need to take care of this overlay with Ham. He needs to get rid, go away, since he's not casting with you today. Ham, I enjoyed the cast with you yesterday. Let's hope to do it again in the future. But for now, it's just me by myself. Slave on Baguette playing Lone Druid. We got Voya on Enigma, Marsu on that Nightstalker, Pasto on Gyrocopter, which leaves Hugo to play Jakiro. Over on Quirt, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6's side, we got Sasu on Shadow Fiend, Aishrin on Bounty Hunter, Eventer will be on our Shadow Demon, and Papa on Windrunner. And not to forget, Orc will be playing that Undying. So, let's have a look at this. I do believe that we're going to have a trial lane of some sort. I would say Windrunner, Undying, and Shadow Demon will do the trial lane. I would prefer them to do it on the Suicide lane down here. So they're going to do that aggressive trial lane, because with playing an aggressive trial lane, just if you go down here... Alright, let's talk about this just for a few seconds. If you go... If this Bounty Hunter, he usually is that long lane solo hero, he will, by the way, get pooled some consumables. Alright, Shadow Demon gave those tangos to him. And as you can see, he's heading toward the safe lane, further proving my point. If you imagine that Bounty Hunter, you go to down that suicide lane, you have a tough time, of course, because you're alone, you have no support, you don't have vision most of the time, and the enemy has all of this, he has these two entryways to come and gank you, this one rather down here, and it's just really, really tough for you as a long lane solo. But if you have an aggressive tri lane, and that's why they call it an aggressive tri lane, with an Undying Shadow Demon and Windrunner in this case, you have three heroes here, and you have more entryways to dive this and be more aggressive, as the name already states. But we have all of Baguette grouped up in the very early game right here, before the creep spawn. They're actually looking for this Windrunner. Needs to be very careful. Hugo has that level 1 ice path. They gotta watch out, they gotta watch out. Gyrocopter, intelligently enough, not yet skilled any of his skills. So either they need that homing missile to set up the stun, to commit them to a team fight, or the rocket barrage for that close-up and personal big DPS. But the situation now completely under control from both sides. They don't want to engage. And Baguette now moving on to their sides as the horn sounds and the game will start. And Bounty Hunter now, since he has his tri lane down here on that hard lane, he will be on that safe lane, and that will give him more opportunities to farm, just more gold and experience potential for him on top lane, which means in turn quicker level 6, quicker track, quicker gank potential, and then of course one of the most important, probably the most important lane for Quirt alongside that tri lane on bottom, of course, is going to be the mid, because Shadow Fiend is very farm dependent, very, very farm dependent, and he has very low base damage early on, so he needs to get these first few last hits, otherwise he will not be able to harass down that Nightstalker who has 5 armor from level 1 on, and just with 2 GG branches, he's got 625 HP. With that Stout Shield, he's completely untouchable from Shadow Fiend's perspective so far. But long lane solo Lone Druid, he's going to have a really easy time against his Bounty Hunter. Lone Druid by himself in a 1v1 situation is one of the strongest, if not the strongest, laner in the game currently. And that's all because of that Misha, the really patriotic, no, not patriotic, it's just a, how to say, I'm looking for a certain word here. It's not coming. Maybe you guys can let me know in the chat, and then in 2 minutes I'll be like, oh yes, that word. But what I'm trying to say is Lone Druid, powerful hero. And on top lane, he's sitting at 6-0, whereas it's just a 2-for-1 on Bounty Hunter. So, you know, one of the things, one of the traps that you fall into in Dota 2, once you hit a certain level of skill, is that you focus too much on harassing the enemy hero. I mean, if you have an advantage on lane, sure, you can harass, you should harass. You need to establish lane dominance, but you need to know the place in the priorities list, you know, of harassing. Is harassing more important than throwing out a raise, for example, as a Shadow Fiend, when there's three melee creeps on like 50 HP? Certainly not. You know, screw that one or two right clicks and you can get in there. Bottom lane, initiation goes out, DK is there, disruption goes out as well, double ice path by Enigma, and Parshaw flies through as well, but Hugo gonna be fine, Shackle flies out, it's a level 2, oh man, Shadow Demon on very low HP, whoa, Baguette Gyrocopter, what a guy, don't wanna F with him, and we have Shadow Demon now falling back a bit, it's very crucial in that engagement, or was very crucial in that engagement, that Jakiro was able to get that double ice path out before. Slowed things down a little bit and gave his support. Oh man, good double raise in the middle lane by SF, forcing out double regeneration for the HP of Nightstalker. And he's completely out of restoratives, and he's only sitting at 460 gold right now. So this is his time to shine. He still has two tangos. He's got a little bit of mana for one more raise. Okay, but that's the thing. Nightstalker, he is going to get his bottle nonetheless right now. And the creep wave is pretty close to his tower. So after this creep, he can even wait for just 10 seconds or so, and then he will have it. But still, a delayed bottle. It will be 3 minutes and about 20 seconds when Nightstalker gets his bottle in mid. Whereas SF in mid has his bottle right now. But I'm keeping my eyes. Oh, good ice path by Jakiro. We have Gyrocopter following up, but an even better disruption by Shadow Demon to slow things down. Oh, there's that big rocket barrage. What was Undying doing there? He needs to heal himself up right there. But look at the right click damage onto Gyrocopter. Good power shot by Windrunner. Kills out the Gyrocopter. But look at those Eidolons from Enigma doing so much damage. They take out Undying. And now the right click's coming in onto Windrunner. The Eidolons actually time out right now. And this right click not going to be enough, as Windrunner is going to salve up in conjunction with that magic stick. And she's running a very weird way. Yeah, she cuts, she eats that tree. And now she's out of harm's way. But in my mind, she could have just continued running up north. Very good exchange, one for one.
I am in your debt.
But the first kill did go to Windrunner on Quirt's side. And that was a dead Gyrocopter for Baguette. So that's a very important kill for the Dire side right now. And in the middle lane, oh, Enigma, he gets that illusion rune on bottom lane. Raze is flying up from Shadow Fiend. And he's going to get that kill on Enigma if he doesn't completely screw this up. Oh my goodness, DK, where is it? Throw it out there. Undying, 2-for-1. Is what he secures for his team. And then bottom lane again, Windrunner. And that's a cool thing about this tri-lane too. You can leave Windrunner alone for a little bit. You can leave her alone because Windrunner is one of the most commonly played long lane solo heroes in the game. 16-for-3 on Bounty Hunter. Is this a bottle for him as well? No, it's already a full Tranquil Boots completed for him. So 16 last hits for 40 minutes, that's 4 a minute, that's completely fine. It's not more than Lone Druid, but you can't really expect a Bounty Hunter to outfarm a Lone Druid in a 1v1 situation, because it's essentially a 2v1. Out of mana is Shadow Fiend, but he does have that regeneration rune in his bottle. And it's almost more than a full minute that Nightstalker has to live on an empty bottle, unless he wants to commit that courier to bottle crow it up. Alright, Spirit Bear, Orb of Venom up. Lone Druid doesn't need that many items so far. Shadow Demon, 04001. Aishrin. So these Tranquil Boots are certainly going to work wonders for me. He's keeping the track out, but you know, even with the Tranquil Boots, it doesn't regen that much mana that he can now stop being defensive. He's now essentially losing the lane at the moment, and he needs support. Middle lane solo kill. No, Enigma was here as well. Level 2 Malphus was enough to take off the Shadow Fiend. And this is the thing as well. Shadow Fiend dying is he really, really gets hurt by dying. His whole game progression is very fragile. If he dies, then he loses half his souls, which is really crucial for him. He needs that base damage. I mean, right now he is still sitting at 80 damage, 80 base damage in on average, with his bottle as well. But right now Nightstalker is out-leveling him in almost one full level. So Nightstalker essentially winning this lane, but not in terms of last hits, I believe. 10 more for SF. But if I were Nightstalker, I would take the experience any day, because with his items and his movement speed right now, level 3 in Hunter of the Night, level 3 in Void, he can start running around and ganking. I'm more of a fan of putting at least one level in Crippling Fear. It really saves your ass sometimes. If you're ganking, for example, an Undying, that 2 or 3 man DK can be a difference between life and death. So you just want to silence him up so that he's not capable of throwing that even out there. Again, now SF, a little bit more cautious. He just wants to get these souls up. Really good use of his raises, though. Slowly gets himself back into the game. And Jakiro, he does have that magic signal. Let's actually have a check of the Tri-Lane versus Tri-Lane participants and their magic stick situation. Jakiro has 1 and all of, no, just 2 out of 3 on Quirt's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 side have a magic stick. Very important item to have. And now Enigma needs to be careful. He's not level 6 yet. Oh, throws down the sentry and now he's going to get spotted out. There's good disruption used by Shadow Demon. We have Slave on the run back. They give up on Enigma. Good shackle even. The bear to Enigma. Beautiful play by Papa. And it's a 4-for-2 right now. Enigma drops on top, and there was really nothing that Lohndrew could do. I mean, he's pretty tanky, 1200 HP, but he didn't want to take any risks, and he was just, Inigon was just completely screwed there. That must be a pretty scary situation too. It's like you put down a sentry, and then there's not only a bounty hunter, but then you can also see two other heroes on the horizon. So again, mid lane Night Stalker now on level 7, still no single point in his Crippling Fear, but his Void is now completely maxed. I don't quite understand it though, because if you do go for 3 levels in Hunter in the Night and do have that bonus movement speed, then why not use that to go ganking? But he's probably going to make me eat my words right now, as he's heading down toward bottom. He's going to camp this bottom rune spot as 8 minute mark is just about to hit. No, he's not, okay. He's now trapped, I believe. Disruption? There it goes, but the nuke flew out already. We have Bounty Hunter here. The chicken is coming in. Marsu on that Night Stalker on the run out. With that track, will Bounty Hunter be fast enough? That's a big question. He does go invisible, and Enigma is here. So Bounty Hunter forced to retreat, and that rune was on top. It's an invis rune. So Night Stalker needs to run himself over there. Is there going to be that really, really sick raise? Is it going to be there? Oh, but he's quite high on HP by now. So the first raise hits. Second raise. 1 second. There we go. Ah, misses. So, Night Stalker invisible, already one bottle charge, sipped up to 300 HP. And that is where I switch over to gold per minute. Look at that, guys. Top 4 farmed heroes, consisting of 3 dire heroes. The only one from Baguette in the top 4 is that Lone Druid with 37 last hits. His bear boots an orb of venom and tranquil boots on the main hero, so he's slowly getting there. Bounty Hunter wrecking some havoc on bot. Gyrocopter, 28 last hits, 9 minutes into the game. That's not nearly as much as he would really like, but let's compare that to Windrunner. What she's sitting at. She actually rotated up towards the top lane to kind of keep tabs on Lone Druid, so I really like that rotation. They put the Bounty Hunter on bottom. They still have a tri lane in effect there, but they now have a very strong laner against Lone Druid. And with that gold item advantage, especially these phase boots, she will be able to deal some good damage. And with the bonus movement speed, she will be able to evade the Spirit Bear a little bit at least. So as long as the Spirit Bear doesn't get lucky with his entangles, then she should be okay. The bear doesn't deal that much damage yet, but it's the entangles that hurt you, because the entangles will keep you in place and might set you up for some bad news. Track, very important. And here's the reassuring thing about track. Where is the vision? Okay, if I go into the dire side vision, then I don't see the Jakiro, which I should be able to though, because he is tracked. Maybe just a little glitch that Valve needs to work on, but you just have the vision of the track hero, of course. Oh man, Bounty Hunter, he eats a cold. Oh man, cold. What's it? I forgot the name. The call down coming now down from Gyrocopter though. Gonna steal a deal on Bounty Hunter's life. It was a freaking ice path. Holy crap, man. What's happening here? I randomly forget those skill names. Night Stalker is here. He deals so much damage. Oh, even better disruption right now by Shadow Demon. Will Undying be able to get away? No, Night Stalker is chasing after him. DK flies out and out goes the nuke. He's blocked in by his own illusions. Tower damage will be enough. No, not. He heals up with the bottle charge. The black hole used by Enigma. Ice path holds Shadow Demon in place as well. It's 3 heroes down. 4 actually, because we have 1 buyback used from Undying. He tries to support Shadow Fiend here and he's low on HP, so those nukes from Night Stalker really hurt him and he's not capable to get a return kill. We have Night Stalker on very low life. So is Gyrocopter, but he will survive as Shadow Fiend is not capable of getting that kill on him. Top tier 1 in the meantime, being pressured by the Lone Druid. He already is sitting on level 9, so Baguette is looking really strong in that regard. Now the bear is moving in for the last hit, while we have Bounty Hunter looking for the deny. Not successful. A lot of gold now going toward the Lone Druid, and you can see the gold per minute. We have a new number 1, guys. It's the Lone Druid, and the pause comes out from Baguette, but so far it's looking really strong for them. It was a very good fight for them on bottom lane, and yeah, that's just very important. The Bounty Hunter, in my opinion, was quite out of position here. He came in this way. Oh, I can't draw while the game is paused. He came in that way, and the ice path just really stopped him in his tracks, and Enigma was waiting in the wings here, came out just in time to support his teammate in that regard. And then even better was when he went underneath the tier 1 tower right here and held 2 heroes in with a black hole, and we had Jakiro rotate over to about this spot here and then shoot his ice path down this way, and it caught both 2 heroes in there as well, and that secured the deal in regards to the Shadow Demon pickoff. Radiant's so it was four heroes attack. Down for Quirt, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and even Undying had to buy back. So look at his items, man. It's 300 gold, not even a magic wand, and just boots. Yeah, for almost 12 minutes into the game, that is a pretty bad state. They're gonna find Lone Druid, but we have Nightstalker here. It's still nighttime, and he throws out that Dust of Appearance. Ah, Lone Druid, he might go down though, because Windrunner is here. So she picks him off, but not before Bounty Hunter goes down. So we have that experience now onto the Lone Druid. Here's SF. Nightstalker is forced to turn around. Is there gonna be a shackle shot by Windrunner? He should have actually kept on chasing and go for that shackle shot. And look at Jakiri, he would have been standing there, would have been a perfect shackle between those two. But, of course, he can't see into the future, but in general, I would have preferred that disable first and then go for the power shot afterwards. So level 3 shackle shot even. The mana was there as well, so don't know why he decided to go for the power shot first, as he had his Shadow Fiend with a crap load of physical damage there. The disable had a way higher priority in that situation in my mind. So correct me if I'm wrong, guys, but wrong order of spells there by Windrunner. I think they could have been able to actually pick up a kill on Nightstalker there. He's quite tanky, sitting at 700 HP, but again, physical damage from Shadow Fiend, very high. Physical damage from Windrunner with Phase Boots, very high also. And she had a level 4 power shot to follow up on, not even mentioning the raises in the back of Shadow Fiend's repertoire. Now we have the movement coming in from Enigma. The track flies out by Bounty Hunter. And the DD run to Shadow Fiend, certainly going to give him an edge. But it could also work the opposite way around if the double damage rune turns out to be the reason that he overextends or does anything else that's kind of questionable in its logic. But so far he's just hanging back. Let's have a look at the net worth as well. Look at Windrunner. Highest net worth on the map so far. It's a completely, it's a completed four staff so far. It's just flying out at the moment. Good entangle. Forced to use a Windrunner. And that's the thing with the Spirit Bear. The entangle is such an X factor. We have that Ogre Club completed on Shadow Fiend. Let me actually have a quick check of the items. So we have that 4 staff on Windrunner, that Ogre Club on SF. Bounty Hunter is sitting on just below 300, so he's looking for drums, I believe, judging by that bracer. And Enigma, he's looking toward his mech. Needs 900 gold, and he will have that. Gyrocopter, is it going for Lifesteal or an Armlet? I guess Lifesteal, but a questionable choice in my mind. You should go for, after those power trades, perhaps for Yasha. But, oh well, we'll see how it goes. Lone Druid, Gloves of Haste on his main hero. Could this be a really late Hand of Midas, is the question. Let's have a look at that chick flying out. It is a Hand of Midas indeed, 14 minutes in. Lone Druid, you are weird. Nothing else to say. Power Treads completed for Nightstalker, needs to fly those out as well. 3-0-0, 33 last, it's gold per minute, though only sitting at 250, as he doesn't have many last hits, but he does have quite a few kills. But of course, if you stay on lane and keep on farming every single wave, then your gold per minute will be a little bit higher than what he has right now. Forest Staff on Windrunner. It's going to be a good tool to work against the ganking Nightstalker. Going to be a good tool to get out of that call down. Going to be a good tool to also take care of being entangled or dodging an ice path or saving your ally that's caught inside it, or a macro pyre, stuff like that. A really important item against the lineup of Baguette so far. And Papa has been playing a solid game so far. 3-1-1, and even managing to pick himself up 66 last hits so far. By the way, let's have a look. Oh, it's only rank 4 in terms of last hits. In terms of last hit kings. Middle lane Enigma, gotta watch out. Look at the minimap. Enigma knows, though. And we have the rotation coming in. Oh, and they're under cover of smoke as well. Jakiro, level 7. And Nightstalker just about hit level 10. And they're going to catch up Windrunner. Out goes the Dust of Appearance. Perhaps not the best move. The sign's a little bit too late. TP by Windrunner is going to be successful. There's no nuke. There's nothing. Ice Path and Void have been used. Good play by Papa. There was a 99% kill for Baguette, but both of them decided to go for their disables right away. And Windrunner's like, fine then. I suppose I shall TP now. Gyrocopter level 9, about to 10. Interesting skill build too. He does have the Helm of the Dominator completed right now. Ulti used by Undying. Support TP is coming in toward the bottom lane. Will it be in time? Disruption goes out. Soulcatch level 3. No points in Shadow Poison. And there's nothing to follow up on that Gyrocopter. The illusions will deal a little bit of damage, but nothing substantial. So let's have a look at the gold difference. 2.5k gold and 4.5k experience in favor of Baguette. Icepath hits on him. We have the dive coming in now from Nightstalker, but support from Bounty Hunters here as well. We have also Papa coming with the 4-staff and the 4-second shackle. So those big 2-man shackles are a big danger for Baguette as well. Shackle flies, catches only Jakiro though. Will the follow-up be there? They're all pretty tanky on Baguette's side. Jakiro gets focused down though. He's the only one that's not so tanky. Enigma has a black hole. I wonder why he didn't go for it. There would have been a 3-man black hole with Justin and Undying standing on the sidelines, but he didn't go for it. For that huge 3-man black hole, perhaps the DPS from Nightstalker would not have been enough. And with Jakiro on the sidelines with no Macropyre and an Ice Path and a Dual Breath, I guess I can understand why Enigma didn't go for that level 1 black hole. In the meantime though, Jakiro gets a Gyrocopter gets a tier 1 tower on bottom lane. He does get focused down by Windrunner though. He is forced in turn to go for the Windrun. The Rocket is standing there, so Papa now needs to get himself out of here. He still has that 4-staff. Power Shot didn't hit on Gyrocopter. He's on the way out, completely out of mana. And he's looking for those 5 extra mana to TP back to base. So here we go, middle lane. Tier 1 tower on the Radiant side, very low on HP. I'm surprised that the Dire side haven't mounted for a big push. Shadow Demon, just about hit level 6. Ice Path does catch Shadow Beam, but he's in a good position in this. Even for Nightstalker on level 10 with 1300 HP, it's a far dive. Because you gotta think, if you consider a dive like this, you know, from here to here, you gotta consider that it takes just a few seconds for a support TP to come in. So a smart support would just place that TP right here, and then you'd basically be screwed. If it's the Shadow Demon with the Disruption and the Soul Catcher, and that Shadow Fiend has time to get set for a triple raise, you're done. This I really like by Undying. You can do that in pubs a lot as well. If you know there's not a lot you can do in middle lane right now, and you know that the enemy hero on lane is nuking down the creep wave, and the next wave is really going to hit dead on in the middle, as if it's like the 0-minute creep wave, and no one's blocking, then go back. Go back toward your creep wave, start blocking, and recreate the equilibrium on your side of the river. It gives you so many advantages, it's very important. There's that BKB, I was wondering, why did he go for a raise on one creep? I mean, it's fine, but why would you do that in a situation like that? And in turn, it was the last creep he needed to complete up his BKB. So again, before this next big teamfight happens, you know, 3.2 or 3.3k gold in favor of Baguette. Experience also highly in favor of them so far. And Lone Druid only has one death to his name right now. 102 last hits. His gold per minute is pretty high already. And let's have a look at his items. The Bear is carrying the Midas. There's a mech completed on Enigma. In the middle lane, we might have some action. There's that Disruption, Dual Breath, Ice Path. Power Shot flies through. From behind, Shackle hits on Nightstalker. Will they be there in time? Tombstone goes down. Ulti flies from that Shadow Demon. There's a black hole used on a BKB Shadow Fiend as well as that Shadow Demon. The Macropyre does a crap load of damage as well. The call down comes down onto all of Quirt, and it's going to be 3 heroes down for them. It's only SF that gets themselves out of there safely. One track kill goes to Bounty Hunter, and he's now on the run out getting chased. 3 for 2 the exchange so far. And it is, oh, a good Ice Path. They have the vision. He was revealed off by Dust of Appearance, and it's 4 heroes dead actually for Quirt. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Baguette playing a good play right there. And very impressive, those quick support TPs into the middle lane. Good play by them. Enigma held them there just long enough, and a 4-for-2 trade is totally worth it. Good deny by Shadow Fiend at least, but he needs to watch out. He might die right here. If this is an entangle, then he's in huge trouble. He's even going even further, but now we have Shadow Demon there. 500 HP is not a lot for a Shadow Fiend facing against 2 huge-ass bears. Spirit Bear gets sent back. Middle tier 1 does drop. Papa, he was iced up. He had no way to deny that tier 1 tower. He's sitting on level 11 though, and he's the second most farmed hero on his team, just behind Shadow Fiend. And it's important that Shadow Fiend survived that, because he did just get his BKB up, but he doesn't want to lose those souls, because if you lose them, you need to invest time to get them back. And You need to be on your way towards your next big item as well. And I'm not even sure what it should be in this case, whether it be a Daedalus or a crit or something else. Maybe it's something like a Lothar's Edge, if they want to place more emphasis on the big team fight, that could also be it. It's just many choices that you can consider for an SF. Bottom lane right now, we have Bounty Hunter here, and that's one thing I do agree with. They need to start, actually, I don't agree that it's only Shadow Demon coming down here as well. Both of those heroes might not be capable of taking down an 1800 HP hero. They need more heroes down here. And this is the type of coordination that I'm missing from Quirt so far. There goes the Disruption, there goes the track, there goes that Amplified Damage, the ulti goes out as well from Shadow Demon, and Lone Druid now just goes with the TP out. Shuriken Toss is this, it's there actually! Are they gonna focus him down in time though? Yes, down goes that Lone Druid, the science is out onto Bounty Hunter, it's gonna be for another 1 second or so. Is there gonna be the nuke though? It does go invisible, but look at that Urn Charge, it's gonna kill him. Nightstalker successful. Where's that Shackle? Two heroes here. So much. Look at that damage output from Quirt heroes. Mini stun is there, and that keeps him in range just long enough for that last right click to do what it takes to kill Nightstalker. Two for one. Good engagement on that Lone Druid. And, you know, I disagree with the fact that it's just two heroes killing him, but if it's two heroes killing him while the other three are on their freaking way there to arrive ASAP to help him out, then I agree. And it worked out fine for them. Enigma still doesn't have the black hole. Of course, a very long cooldown is what it takes. It's a very long cooldown is what it takes. No, the very long cooldown is what makes the black hole not suck as... oh my god. A black hole is a long cooldown, guys, and he still doesn't have it. And it was a long time before, you know, since he used it. That's what I'm trying to get at. Holy cow, that bear is fast as well. And he has his relic on him, too. 22-minute relic. Even though he went for Hand of Midas later on as well. Undying, silenced up. There's a disruption. There's an ice path holding him, though. The rocket en route toward that Undying. And he's going to go down for sure. Now we have Nightstalker getting attacked by Bounty Hunters. Just to help him out. There's the black hole into BKB Shadow Fiend. Way worth it, in my opinion. The nuke from Jakiro doesn't do enough, as he's completely magic immune. And the death soul release from Shadow Fiend gets the kill onto Nightstalker, but still, it's still a good fight for Baguette. They did have to invest that black hole once more, and the mech wasn't enough to keep his ally alive, but it's still good for Baguette. They are securing themselves that position on the map, and more importantly, they are making sure that Lone Druid has the space. And as you can see, there's that relic. He doesn't have Midas, he already has Tranquil Boots and a little bit of extra magic resistance, and 500 gold more. Just 500 gold, and he will have a Radiance, and that will be too much for those low HP heroes on Quirt to deal with. Oh, there goes that first Malphite stun, secondary stun going to follow up, the Ice Path holds him in place, but good defensive disruption though, call down, coming down onto two, it's going to be a double kill I believe. There it goes, double kill to Gyrocopter, three heroes still down, now just Shadow Fiend reviving, they lost two at the tier 2 on bottom, and that TP should be cancelled I believe. There's that stun by the Centaur. Ah, where's that Micro Man? Ah, oh, where is the micro at? It could have been so good. Bounty Hunter Invis lurking around. But this is not really... Oh my goodness. Gyrocopter auto attacking away on Bounty Hunter. That was just really, really questionable play by him. The rocket even flying out right now. The ice path does miss. But he doesn't have... He should TP right now because that rocket is coming in. It's by now it should be too late. He does have two charges on his wand. I'm gonna keep my eyes on this guy, and he does go invisible finally, so... Still, not the best move by Bounty Hunter to chase after three or four heroes with one of them having dust off cooldown with no support in the vicinity. So he's now forced to just run back to base and thus waste more time, lose more potential gold and experience at that. Middle lane, we have an Invis Nightstalker gonna take care. Oh, Shadow Fiend forced to use that BKB. If he were to die right now, that would be even worse. Shackle flies out, and he is fine. It's a very expensive save for him to use that BKB charge, but look at, man, imagine if only he had died right there. Papa doing a good having a good game with Windrunner so far, but he does need the Shadow Fiend to carry the game. He can't do it. That's a relic. Radiance completed. Where's that bear at? Buying it up right now. Gonna get sent back to his holy, to his master. And yeah, he should call him back right now, I believe. He's just healing up a bit. Jakiro, Staff of Wizardry. One item I like on Jakiro is a Rod of Atos. It gives you that good. Actually, Rod of Atos, even on Heroes like Silencer, is really cool. I just like the item a lot. It's kind of underrated in my mind. It gives you a crap load of HP, it gives you some good intelligence, and the slow is really strong. And they even buffed it a few versions ago. So Rod of Atos was already strong when it was released, but nobody picked it up, so Valve said, fine, we're going to buff that slow from 40 to 50%. I think it was 40 to 50. Let me actually check. But no, we have action. I cannot check. Look at Lone Druid going to work a wind on with that burn. Bounty Hunter helps his buddy out a little bit, though. But now that bear is committed, chasing after. We have the rotation coming in. Gyrocopter going to meet SF. Both of them turn around, but now Nightstalker here as well. Now they're going to switch targets onto Undying. The rocket coming. Silence out onto Undying. He's going to get focused down a bit. One last click, and the flag cannon from Gyrocopter does enough damage. And now that's already it for this engagement. It's a 4v5 already. The disruption has to be used defensively. And SF on the run out as we have Nightstalker now chasing after. Bounty Hunter along with the rest of his team. Two heroes dead. Baguette is just steamrolling through these guys right now. And Quirt 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 is by all means crumbling, I think, underneath the pressure that Baguette is forcing upon them. And just generally better movement by Baguette so far. The Nightstalker pick is working wonders for them so far, because it's just this really tanky, high mobility hero with a nuke, a slow, and a silence to lead the way for the other heroes like Jakiro and even Gyrocopter. And it's just this big, fast, and stunny silencer silencing up meat shield that you have, essentially. Blink up from Enigma. He has a blink dagger, by the way. Disruption going to save his ass from that ice path. But no, the duration a little bit too long. BKB has to be used by Sheriffine again. He goes for the ultimate, but everybody dodges it. It's going to hit no one but Misha. Poor bear going to go down. But I guess it's fine. Turns off the ice path. Hits on nobody. Rocket is now getting ready to fly against after this really bad, really crazy zombie. Black Hole used on two heroes. Macro Power flies out as well. Call down to follow up. No BKB for Shadow Fiend. Force Staff out from Dad. But it's not enough. It's Papa, not Dad. And that is it so far. Two heroes again down for Quirt. And the Radiant side now marching up the high ground, taking care of business as usual. Tier 3 tower under siege. And this bear has become too strong, too fast for him. Shack out onto Gyrocopter, but nothing to follow up so far. Look at the net worth. Oh man, Gyro even richer than the bear. How does that happen? How does that even happen? Manta style and an MKB almost completed up, so they are not kidding around. They do want to make sure that no funny things like talismans or Heaven's Halberds or even butterflies can diminish the damage. So in general, looking pretty good for Baguette. These wards also quite nice for the Dire, but keep in mind Roshan has not been attempted by either side yet. And right now would be a pretty good time for Baguette to consider this. They can now farm their woods quickly. They can perhaps go for a gank somewhere. They all have their top tier 1 and bot tier 1 still standing. And all of the outer towers for the Dire side are gone, which means that should they go for Roshan, and if you look at the spot on the minimap right here, then there's no towers standing here to TP to and to have this very short walk to the toward the Roshan pit. So if they go there, then they have many advantages. They have the advantage in a team fight. They have the advantage when it comes to the distance to the Roshan pit. At their higher levels, they have just better items, that which is why I said they have better team fight. And those are the reasons why Baguette can just nonchalantly go for Roshan right now. And they can be about 80% sure that Quirt on the Dire side will not even be capable of challenging the Roshan, you know? That's just the deal with this situation here. On top lane, Shadow Fiend on the way back. That BKB ultimate orb is coming up. What's flying out to him? It's a Yasha. He needs 600 gold, then he will have a Manta style completed. But keep in mind, guys, he needs a lot more than that. He needs more items to carry his team. I mean, look at Baguette. I'm going to throw those items up right now. MKB, bam, that's the first one. You got the Manta style, you got the Helm of the Dominator, you got the Mech and the Blink on Enigma, and you have a Staff of Wizardry on Jakiro, guys. Hello? Lone Druid, of course, his bear is stacked as heck. He already has a Hyperstone, Radiance, so Assault Cuirass completely underway for Lone Druid. He's even jacking that ancient spot from Quirt at the moment, and you can see them all, you know, just hanging back. The middle racks are down for them, and they are just defending out, and they know that Baguette is taking Roshan as we speak, and they know they cannot do anything about it. Papa still just had ultimate orb, so that hex will not even be up anytime soon. The power shot now spots out the Roshan attempt, and oh, is he gonna go for the jack? Oh my goodness, Papa. Don't do at least if you go for the jack, put an item down before you do so. Okay, he didn't go for the jack, but he tried to do something even more sneaky. For example, Sexy Bamboo who just left AL. I wish you the best of luck, by the way, buddy. Sexy Bebo, he would have force staffed in there, would have dropped like the magic wand. He would have force staffed in there and would have trying to do what? To pick up that Aegis and then be like, I'm Sexy Bebo, bitches. I got the Aegis like I always do. But what Windrunner tried to do was to try and anticipate when Roshan drops, give himself vision with the power shot, and then just kill the Aegis before they were able to pick it up. That was what he was going for, and unfortunately it failed, but that would have been huge had it had it succeeded. Low Druid, Aegis up on him. What else do we have? Nothing new for Gyrocopter, but money. 2.3k gold on him. Four staff completed on Shakiro right now, and Enigma going for that BKB. I mean, things are looking up quite well for Baguette up to this point. We have a smoked up Quirt. Again, Undying. He's always going to get caught out. Maybe a little bit an over-ambitious BKB by Nightstalker, but I believe it's still 10 seconds, so he's completely fine. Now we have the Illusions coming in. The burn from the Radiance Burn does so much. There's that Shackle. They should actually now focus down on the Lone Druid, but he's so tanky. Rocket Barrage flies up from Gyrocopter. The teamfight is split up into two. Up here, Undying still getting focused by Nightstalker. Ice Path catches Shadow Demon. He gets four-staffed out. But will it be enough? Good two-man shackle by Windrunner. This actually saves everybody's life. And that gives Quirt one more chance to fight this. But Brown, who is Brown? It's Bounty Hunter. He's invisible. Is there a gem? Yes, there's a gem on Nightstalker. And there's no way Bounty Hunter can get away from this. The stun, the animation is cancelled. But now that's slow from the void. Oh, Bounty Hunter, he tries to do something. I'm half HP. I will deny myself the noodle creeps. So there's that one pick off. Bounty Hunter not able to buy back, not enough gold on him. BKB Manta style, as I said, on Shadow Fiend completed, 550 gold. And now we have the set of rag. If Baguette get this, then I believe if they win the team fight, that might ensue right now. Oh, look at that flat cannon doing all that damage on the Shadow Fiend. Oh, that glyph was horribly timed, to be honest. Horribly timed. Now they start attacking, and the glyph is already gone. BKB used by Shadow Fiend. He goes in for the DPS, the ulti onto Jakira from Shadow Demon. He's really far in, though. There's a huge black hole used by Enigma as well. It catches two. Black ultimate used by Shadow Fiend, but it's not going to be enough. Not at all. Four heroes down. Now Bounty Hunter respawns. The top barracks going to go down. And as I said, there's that GG call by SF. Baguette take the win. Over Quirt. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 for the defense. And they remain very good track for the defense season 3, which is sponsored, of course, by Own3D TV as well as Rockat. The winner takes home 10,000 euros, 20,000 euros overall invested by these amazing esports companies into our tournament. Of course, brought to you by JoinDota.com. So, a big shout out to those companies and the sponsors, as well as JoinDota, and you guys for watching. It's been a very, very fun game. Baguette take this win very well deservedly. And I believe that is it for the night. Let's have a look at the endgame screen, though. Just want to have a quick last look and a quick last glance at all the items that we have so far. Say, Enigma, he didn't have the BKB, but didn't need it. Good play and good game so far by him. All the black holes had at least two heroes in them so far in the game, or one BKB'd up SF and had him disabled so that he couldn't dish out that damage that Quirt so desperately needed. So overall, an amazing game by Baguette. And I'm really loving this Fight Club flair here by the Lone Druid players. So all of them played quite well. Quirt, good luck in the next few games. And thank you guys for watching. Again, a big freaking shout out to our sponsors, Rockat, as well as Own3D TV, for making this possible. This has been myself, Epi, standing in for Tobiwan Kenobi, as he's over in Malaysia. Flirting with them Asian girls and casting a little bit of Dota 1 while he's at it. And anything else I'm trying to say? No, just thank you and see you guys soon. That was it for the defense tonight, and perhaps I'll do a viewer game after that. So stay tuned, guys. Bye bye.
I said good day, sir!